I got this. I don't know what it is, and it does not taste the way I thought it would taste. It was a dollar, so, you know. What is going on here? So I was walking along for breakfast, and J5? This J5?
Yeah,
J5. J5. Okay.
Michelin, 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 Michelin.
I'm making my video because it's the Michelin star place. Good when there's a waiting area.
So here's the problem. Ran J5 is great and the food is awesome, and because of that I was enjoying eating it and didn't really feel much. But I can tell you about it. First off, their signature main dish is some sort of crab omelet, and I made the mistake of not ordering that. I didn't really know that that was the signature dish until I saw that literally everyone else was just ordering that. It was also really expensive. Compared to most Thai food, it was easily 10 times the price. So even though $50 for a one-star Michelin restaurant is pretty good value, compared to Thailand standards, that's really expensive. And I didn't really want to spend that much money, so I got a slightly cheaper option, which was still really nice. Then there's the problem about that. That food was delicious. Really, really nice. Except, for me, I couldn't really tell the difference between that food and just another really good street food, except for the fact that it was still about 10 times the price. So, is it worth going to Ran J5? Unless you're really, really into food, I'd say probably not. there's so many other great places in Thailand to eat that give really similar food, and I can't tell the difference, so unless you can, I'd just eat anywhere else. Anyway, back to the video. So here's the other problem. Again, I was having a lot of fun and didn't really film a lot here. But again, I can talk about it. So we went to the Mahanakhon Skywalk. I think that's what it's called. And even though I haven't really used my architecture degree, I can still appreciate cool buildings, and this was a really cool building. We were about 47 floors up, and there was a 360 view of the entirety of Bangkok. And first off, just the size of it was incredible. To see that many skyscrapers crammed that close was really a lot bigger than Melbourne. It makes me realize how small the city of Melbourne is. Anyway, at 47 floors up, you can walk straight out onto a sheet of glass, and it was really cool. One of the perks of traveling during this time is that there's not a lot of tourists. So a lot of the touristy places are significantly cheaper than what they'd usually be, and significantly quieter than what they'd usually be. We paid about $40 to go up there, which is about half the price of what it normally costs. And there's usually about 2,000 people that pass through every night, and we were told that on our night, they were expecting about 300 or 400. It was really quiet. You could walk out on the glass for pretty much as long as you wanted. You could come back, you could go back out onto the glass. There was a bar up there with heaps of seats available, and we actually ended up staying for ages. And to be honest, it was one of the highlights of Bangkok. So this one I can recommend, and I do recommend. So if you're in Bangkok, check it out. As for now, I hope you've enjoyed the video. I know it's very late. There are more videos coming as always, and I will slowly get around to posting them. But hope you enjoyed this one. Thanks for watching.